Hello, my name's Jupiter Hadley, and today we're doing another version of Jupiter Plays All the Games, this time with the Playcrafting plus Extra Life Game Jam. The Playcrafting plus Extra Life Game Jam was a game jam that seemed to go along with an event that happened at a physical location, though they did ask people to participate online as well. It was an event put on by Playcrafting to support the charity Extra Life, I believe. And the idea of this game jam was to make games that had some sort of educational aspect to it. I've been playing all of the games that are entered in this jam for about a minute each. Links will be in the description so you can check them out further and play them yourself. This video is brought to you in part by the lovely people on Patreon who support me so I can continue to record all of these wonderful indie games. So if you'd like to support me or check out any of my info, all that will also be in the description. Thank you very much for watching and liking and commenting. Next. First, we're playing It's About Ethics and Journalism. All right. I'm an editor.
We've needed an ace reporter like you for a long time.
Okay.
We're losing readers to fake news every day, but gosh darn it, we've got integrity. We'll never stop telling the truth.
All right.
And that's what you're gonna do.
Tell
you're gonna
truth.
Give people the truth, but you're gonna make it catchy too. I hired you because you're the best, kid.
I'm the best.
Now's your chance to prove it.
How? Alright, new journalist hired to something. The Daily Fail in order to combat something hired a new reporter covering general issues from national security. The reporter has over 20 years of experience and we're proud to welcome them to our staff. Hired new journalist to report top with reporting to reporting? Well, sure. Oh, I didn't like that. 20 years of experience reporting with top-tier newspapers. Alright, to cover today's top issues in order to combat fake news. That's pretty good. Pass. Okay, catchy. It was pretty boring. However, you know, we did alright. Horrible teacher sends too much homework. Fourth grade teacher who may be blank. Who may be... maybe undergoing a personal trauma. Today I sent 3 hours of homework to our excellent students. These little rats deserve it. Students quoted Futterbutt as saying while scratching the wart on her nose. I really can't afford the year trip to blank on my teacher's salary and I'm going to make them pay for it. To Aruba? Sure. Students had a different perspective. I once saw her blank, said the 10-year-old. I'm scared. Once saw her feeding spiders that lived in her hair. Oh, wait. Once saw her with a cookbook on how to eat little boys. At press time, Futterbutt could not be reached for comment as she was doing volunteer. Oh, nope. What do I have for the last one? She was feeding the spiders that lived in her hair. Sure. I don't know if that's quite truthful, but it's definitely catchy. Next. We're playing History 205 exam. I'm just gonna play single player.
Welcome to your time jumper.
Okay.
Brought to you by Brill Koi Dar. Please be careful on your journey to the past and follow the rules of time travel. 1, do not see yourself or all reality will be lost.
Okay.
For this reason, your time jumper is equipped with an automated eject feature. 2, do not interact with people in the past or all reality will be lost.
It's kind of freezing
Welcome
up.
To your history
okay.
Test.
I can't really hear her over the voice. I also can't seem to move. So I've plugged in a controller, though it doesn't say anywhere that I need one. It looks like you do. I'm not sure what this person's saying, but it's something about collecting stuff. The movement of the camera's a bit funky. Crystals. Next jump. Alright, so I need a lot of crystals. 20. I like sort of the colored tiles and the look of this strange world. However, I don't think we're gonna get 20 crystals before the jump. Come Come on, grab that one. It's right there. There's like three over here. Maybe we'll do it. Out of my way, golden elephant. 10. I just can't seem to run into them. Got it. I don't have whatever items it wants me to have, though. So I didn't do very well. It's an interesting idea. I feel like the camera angle needs some tweaking. Next. We're playing Little Fixer. Rawr. So we have to click on things on the screen to stop. There we go. Get rid of that. To stop disaster from happening. Oh, they were hungry, so we gave them fruit. Oh, that's it. Just three little cute games. I liked it. The minigame is inspired by the idea of helping kids become more creative with problem solving. With solving problems. We also want to helping others. They did a really good job. It's a cute, fun little game. I wish there was even more minigames to it. But yeah, next. We're playing Cute Fantasy. My sister is stuck. Please help her. Okay. You can pick up items by pressing E. These graphics are really nice. E. Okay. We've got lots of coins now. E. It looks like fire there, but I'm just going to ignore it. Please help me. Alright. Can we make a wish in the well? Collect a pillow. Let's make a wish in the well. I'm kind of trying to go up top, and it's not working. Alright. Oh. Hi. Did I help you? Like, I don't feel like I did, but yeah. I don't think this game is quite finished. It looks like it's got a few bugs that need to be worked out. I'm also not quite sure how to fix things or why the road's on fire. Oh, sorry about that. Oh, I can stand on her head. That's it. Next. We're playing The Hungry Dragon. This game is only released to source code, so you have to download the Got It? Maybe, that's how you say it. Engine and then run it through there. I found it very easy to do. Someone who's never used the engine before, it was pretty straightforward. So you probably could too. Right, do I need to eat these? Tiny, Lieutenant Tiny Talon. I'm gonna eat these little wormies in this person's room. I'm clearly an escaped pet. General Fast. Oh, is that it? Congratulations, you win. That's pretty cute. Just a simple little game. Quite a mishmash of graphics that make this look like a very dirty room. That's cute. I love this little creature. It's like a bearded dragon, I think, or something. Next. We're playing Boric. Alright, press to start. Play. Awesome. History. Let's do it. Scene 1.
Hi. I am going to introduce you to my friend, Boric.
Okay.
He is 8 years old and goes every day to a Mexican school.
Okay.
What I am going to tell you is how he managed to change his life.
Alright, I wasn't sure about that whole white screen thing, so I'm going to go to menu and just play, I think. World 1. But that would give you the lesson about how this game is helpful to you. I'm, like, focusing now. So hardcore. That gives you sort of the lesson, because this is a game about, like, childhood obesity and making the better choices to help not only yourself, but your self-esteem. Alright, so let's go to the next level. Fiery fries. Yeah, that's not good. I like these hand-drawn, like, burgers and stuff. They look really interesting. So it's just a very simple game. Oh, we can double jump. It's a very simple game to control. Oh, I ate the burger. I didn't mean to eat the burger, but I ate the burger. Darn it. There we go. Nope. Next. We're playing Blood Cell Hero. This is a VR game, so I'm not sure if I can play it. You are the hero of this game. You must, I don't know, this is an infectious blood cell. It can damage your body and be fatal. You must shoot the infection blood cells to keep your host healthy. Alright, I might be able to play this. Ah, I can play this without a VR. It says it is for a VR, though. But so far, we're not doing the best. Yeah, we've let a couple go through. Nope. They don't quite go as fast or where I kind of want them to. Sometimes they bounce off of the regular blood cells, so it's a challenging game. Player has 0 points. I'm not doing well at all. And the time is not. The time is giving up on me. There we go, we got one. Kind of hits those spike bits. The graphics are quite nice. Some detail on these little red blood cells. Some texture. Next. Last but certainly not least, we're playing Tuscan Flame. This is a multiplayer game that can be used with keyboards or Xbox 360 controllers. We're using Xbox 360 controllers. I'm playing with Lewis.
Hello.
You're probably not going to be able to hear him too well. That's fine. Alright, player one is like the person on a dragon. Player two is an elephant with a top hat. So, Lewis is going to be player... Oh. How do you move?
Any of these.
Mine's not working. Oh, maybe I need to be keyboard? Ah, I'll be keyboard. Ah. You, like, got through to the other side quite a lot faster. I can't seem to push anything.
Yeah, no, this is like...
I feel like I need to do something, but I only looked at the controls for keyboard. Oh, no.
Well, we screwed that up.
Yeah, I don't know what my controls are. I feel like I can pull, or like you push and I pull, but no. I don't know what my controls are because I looked at the Xbox 360 controls because I assumed we could use two of them. So I'll have to look. All right, arrow keys, shift, and question mark. So shift can do tongue. Maybe it's this shift? Ah, that shift. So maybe that can move rocks, yeah.
Yeah, there we go.
Oh, look, question mark. Ooh, that doesn't look very good. All right.
It's a fireball.
Yeah, let me pull it forward. Or do we need to push it into that hole?
I think in the hole is where we need to go.
All right, so you need to push it. I can't push it, okay. So there you go.
There we go.
Now and I'll pull it. One. Yeah. There we go.
Excellent.
We're friends. We're little hoppers.
I love the characters.
The characters are super cute. Oh, I can melt ice.
I think this is like a pressure pad.
No, so... no. It's just I step on it.
No, it is.
Oh, wait, that. But I mean this next one up here.
Oh, you need to let me out.
Yeah. Here you go. Very cute game. Wait. Let me pull the first one first. Oh, I can't.
Good thinking.
No, don't push them together, babe. You gotta push it into the thing. Push it in. Go. Push it down. Now in. Good. Alright, let me grab this one. There you go. That was my helpfulness. Anyway, thank you very much for watching and liking and commenting. As I said, this is the last game entered in the jam, and it's been pretty fun to play them all. So yeah. Bye.
Bye.